Forum. Dr. Gaurav Sharma had completed his PhD from GK University Haridwar in the year 2006. After that, he has worked on various positions in Geological Survey of India, and now he is heading the Geological Survey of India, NRC, Dehradun, Uttarakhand. He is one of the very young and dynamic scientists and a very enthusiastic scientist in field. And to his professional recognition, he received Biodiversity Conservation Award in the year 2019, nominated by the MoEF Secretary, Delhi, for 17th meeting of Conference of Parties, CITES, COP17, received ConocoPhillips Water and Biodiversity Stewardship Scholarship Award, nominated by Secretary for 28th meeting of Animal Committee CITES. He is one of the experts of IUCN in Odonata Specialist Group, received Conference Participation Award from the 6th and 7th South Asian Symposium on Odonatology, and he has published more than 11 books. He has published more than 70 research publications, and he is also an author to 43 book chapters which are published by him. He has participated in many conferences and seminars. To the best of my knowledge, he is one of the most dynamic and smiling scientists of ZSI, who always say yes to everything. Sir, welcome to the forum. And now I am handing over this forum to you with the talk of yours. It's all yours, sir. Please go ahead.
Okay, thank you. Just I'm uploading because people are pressing that present on. So it is distracting. So please tell them don't to press any button.
I am requesting all the participants, so please don't press any button, particularly present now button. Don't press because it's disturbing the presenter and removing that slide from the box. So please stick to the plan and don't present now. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Please go ahead.
Thank you, Dr. Anil Mahapatra. Thanks for the invitation for deliver this lecture. And I also thanks our director, Dr. Geological, Dr. Kailash Chandra, sir, the Director of Geological Survey of India, who given us permission so that we are with you, with all of you. And the initiative taken by Dr. Anil Mahapatra, the research expert from ZSI, will deliver lecture and interact with you all. So it is due to your support and cooperation that it is continue, and today I am with all of you. So I will, if you people don't distract anything, you will visualize the things, and whatever little bit knowledge which I got, that you people will also little bit you will also get benefited. So I am moving with this to my presentation. So as you know, that diversity and conservation in India. Just first, to tell the youngster that Geological Survey of India is the subordinate office of Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, and our headquarter is at Calcutta, and Geological Survey of India is having 16 regional centers. Now this all information, I will move fast because all information are available, and you will get those by moving to websites and to Google search or to us also. So as you all know that India is recognized as one of the 17 mega biodiversity countries, and also we are among the 20 like-minded mega diverse countries. And in India we are having four biodiversity hotspots. So many times the question, if you people will appear for interview and all, they will ask how many biodiversity hotspots still in India. So some will say 2, 3 like that. So one first is in Eastern Himalaya. In that only we are having Arunachal Pradesh part, and Indo-Burma we are having only Purvanchal Hills. Third is Western Ghats, and fourth in Sundaland we are having parts of Nicobar Islands. So if you see this slide, you will see that India, Indonesia, Australia, Mexico, they are in Brazil, they are in the middle. It shows that we are the country which those are rich in highest culture diversity and also highest biological diversity. And this papaya, Nigeria, Cameroon, they are having highest cultural diversity. These countries are having highest biological diversity. And more than 200 countries throughout the world. And the, some countries, they are not rich in anything. They are not having that much cultural diversity and not having any biological diversity. But we are blessed that in India, we are rich in each and every thing. So this, just I will take you this move, I will pass. This all you know, this is the world map where we will we are existing, India, China, Russia, what are the parts. And then if you see, there is another one term that also people will ask, biogeographical realm or ecozones. The world is divided into 8 ecozones, Arctic, Neotropic, Paratic, Afrotropic, Indomalaya, Ashdasia. In this, Oceania and Antarctic is not visual. So in India, we are having Indomalaya part also, and we are also part of Paleartic region also. These regions, they are divided due to a distributional pattern of terrestrial organisms. Just I am moving. Slide is stuck, I think. So if I think I think someone is making a distraction, I will reattach again the presentation. Please don't press any button. I request Dr. Anil also, if someone is making disruption, you remove the fellow.
Yeah, I had already removed 2-3 persons, but still some.
Okay, no problem. Just I'm connecting again.
Yes, sir. Please, all participants, don't upload, don't present now.
सर सॉरी मैं बीच में बोल रहा हूँ
जस्ट वेट जस्ट आई एम कनेक्टिंग विद अनदर नेटवर्क डिस्ट्रैक्शन इज देयर सो नाउ आई एम कनेक्टिंग विद अनदर
सर पर वेरी सॉरी
ऑल विल फिनिश सो बी पेशेंट दैट इट हैपेंस बिकॉज़ नाउ ऑल वी आर इन आवर house we are listening and due to network problems and all sometime it happens so I hope I am visible now presentation is visible
not yet sir presentation is not yet visible sir
okay one second
now it's visible sir now it's visible.
Only visual.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I will move ahead to the where I was. So I given little information about biogeographical realms, and this in this slide, if you see, you will see the. Major continental divide showing drainage into major ocean and sea of the world and the gray area this area has not drained into the ocean and just if we will say any biodiversity hotspot that you all know till now 36 biodiversity hotspots in the world designated so that the area chosen those areas which are threatened and with destruction, biodiversity threatened. So these are information available. I move ahead. These are 36 biodiversity hotspots of the world. And this, if you see in this slide, in Africa, Asia Pacific, Europe, Central Asia, North and Central America, and South America. So these are the 36 biodiversity hotspots in the five regions. And if you see in this picture, you will see the darker areas, they are more rich in diversity than the other areas which are lighter. So now I move to India just to understand, to make you to the mammals. Just we will understand what wealth we are having and how blessed we are. So if you see India, we are having deserts, we are having Himalayas, we are having a river networks all around, and we are having different types of lakes, and it is covered by sea all around. So whatever the ecosystems and habitats all over the world, we are blessed that we are in our own country. If we will move ahead in our country, each and every part, there is no need to move at any place. So these are the, in next slide, these are the 10 biogeographic zones of India. And then these 10 biogeographic zones also divided into 26 biotic provinces. So if we will, I will say that diversity and strength of India, that you see the forest in that area, hills, ranges are there all over India, river network is there, lakes, then climate, it varies each area to area. And now I come to that we are having only 2.4% of total land area of the world, but our country sports 16.7% of the world population. And in terms of animal diversity, we are till today 1,02,161 species recorded from India. In that, 65,710 species are the insects. Hey, this 1,02,161 species is only 6.52% of total world still recorded species, 15,64,647. So with only 6% fauna we are having, we are among the 17 biodiversity, mega biodiversity countries. So you will find that some countries, they are not having even 1% or 2% biodiversity. So if we will say that from India, we are having the representation of, if animal group, we will say 26 phylum. Till today, the species recorded from these 26 phylum. In the throughout the world, there are 36 phylum. So now I come to the mammals. Mammals, you all know that animal possessing mammary or milk producing glands for nursing their young. Another factor, animal possessing a body hairs. And mammals, if you see that we ranges from small to big whales and elephants. So in the national symbols, the mammals, you see the lion, capital of Soka at Sarnath, their national emblem. It is taken from the lion, capital of Soka at Sarnath. Ratanjali Sivan is presenting. What is distracting?
Oh, I had removed her.
No problem. No problem. I upload again. No problem.
सर सॉरी क्या आप मुझे हिंदी में भी बता सकते हैं सर ये
प्रेजेंटेशन सॉरी इट विल हैपन व्हेन सम आर अवेयर ऑफ यूज ऑफ दिस एंड सम आर नॉट सो देयर इज नो फॉल्ट बाय एनीवन लिटिल बिट वी विल अगेन आई विल अपलोड डोंट वरी इट इज बेटर दैट वी आर moving in a phase wise 10 10 15 15 slides. I will see another.
क्या हो गया आपका प्रेजेंटेशन को
कोई नहीं प्रेजेंटेशन को नहीं वो डिस्ट्रैक्ट हो गया ना बंद हो गया वो डोंट वरी अभी ओपन होगा
हाँ एक बार क्लोज करके फिर से अपलोड कर दीजिए
वो ना किसी ने प्रेजेंट नाउ क्लिक कर दिया ना तो उसका अपलोड हो गया
some people who are not acquainted, they are always pressing present now, that's creating problem.
They are thinking that they from present now they will.
They are also acquainted.
No problem.
They are also learning many things.
No problem. Just 2 minutes. It's opening. थोड़ा कूल हो जाइए, दो मिनट के लिए. अपलोड हो रही है वो. फाइव सेकेंड मोर.
It seems that your file is very low, very much heavy.
Not very heavy, Gopal ji.
Like Gaurav Sharma sir.
Dolphin se jyada heavy nahi hai. So please, I request that now no one will, and also Dr. Neil, now don't accept anyone to join.
Yes, sir.
So, please don't press any button. One second. Is now visible?
No, sir.
Not yet.
सेम बेसिक स्ट्रोक तो प्रेजेंट नाउ को सिलेंडर काढ़े दिल को
नो आई थिंक इट्स कमिंग
यस नाउ इट्स कमिंग सर कमिंग गवर्नमेंट को तो ऑप्शन आते देख
करता हूं मैं एक सेकंड
नो सर नॉट येट कम सर
आएगा अब आएगा बाली टेंशन मत लीजिए आएगा भी
मैं वेट कर रहा हूँ बहुत पेशेंसली
तभी तो अब वेट कर रहे इसलिए तो आरत लो
आएगा Yes,
can sir.
Okay.
Full screen कर लिए सर, full screen.
हो रहा गोपाल जी, हो रहा है full screen.
सर 460 स्लाइडे हैं तो टाइम तो लेगा ही.
टेंशन मत लीजिए.
ये तो मैं बोल रहा था कि
हम प्रेजेंट करेंगे, टेंशन मत लीजिए, 4 बजे फ्री कर देंगे सबको. ओके वेलकम All of you, so mammals concept is clear. Now I said that it is also in our national symbol, in the national emblem, also the national animal of India is a tiger, panther, tigress, National heritage animal is Asiatic elephant, and national aquatic animal is our Ganga River dolphin. So now these are the identification characters to identify mammals. So these all informations are available. So now, just if you see that what is the status of mammal in the world? Till today, 6,495 species recorded from all over the world, and in that India. Till today, around 427 species reported. That only counts 6.57% of the global mammalian species. And if you will say that that will represent only 48 families and 12 orders. Throughout the world, till today, 27 orders are existing. Earlier, they are saying 29, so two are merged in that. Even the cetacean is now made an infra order, and it is now in Artiodactyla. And if we mammalian diversity, if we will say in the world and India and Himalaya, so in world 27 orders, India 12, in Himalaya 11 orders. Families 167, India 48, in Himalaya 36. Species wise, already I told you, besides that 427 species, in India we are having 338 subspecies of mammals are there. So total, if we will say species and valid subspecies, the total number of mammals is 765. And in that, the 45 species are endemic. So this, if you look on that, these are the 12 orders in which that were recorded from India out of 27. So in that, we have provided the number of families in the India and the world, order-wise, number of genera, number of species. If you see Chiroptera in the bats, we are having 121, highest diversity of bats in India. Then Rodentia, 100. Then Artiodactyla, 68. Then Carnivora, 60. Then Primates, 23. And they are here, Iranus Morpha and Sorico Morpha. They are now merged in Lipotypla. So by behavior also, you will differentiate between the mammals, and they kept in the different order according to their behavior. Four-footed mammals, Carnivora, Artiodactyla, erect posture mammals, some primates, flying mammals, Chiroptera, global gliding mammals, flying squirrel, arboreal mammals. These all informations are available, burrowing mammals, aquatic mammals, terrestrial mammals, toothless. So if you look about the adaptive radiation in mammals, these are the terrestrial, these are fossorial, these are arboreal, these are aquatic, these are volant, these are gliding. And there also I given the picture of according to their adaptive radiation, and also according to their feeding habit, herbivores, omnivores, frugivores, carnivores, insectivores. And their preferred habitat for mammals. Their according to habitat wise, they are also divided into different families. They are kept in the different families and in the different groups. Like that in insectivoria. These are the three families, and these all I will not go in that because just my purpose is that I will give you some idea, I will give you some awareness. Mammal is the most known group in which more than 5,000-6,000 books published all over the world. So if you see diversity in feeding, already I told you herbivores, carnivores, insectivores, all types of mammals. And if you say the ranking world, we are having the 9th rank in the world as per number of species. Indonesia is number one, 670 species, then Brazil, then China, then Mexico, then Peru, then Colombia. And the species which are threatened, where there is diversity also, there is species are threatened. In Indonesia, 191. In India, 93. As per IUS red data listing. So now I just move you because the habitats are more important. Animal, they will survive if we will leave, we will not disturb their habitat. So we just move where we will find these mammals. This is in the Himalaya. I will take you from Himalaya to the near to the sea. This is in the Ladakh, some of the cliffs. I will move fast. This is a lake in which we done the surveys. Turistal Lake. And this is in the Ladakh region. Then this is in Lahul Spiti, Himachal. This is also in the Lahul area, near to Ladakh. This is Pin Valley. So These are Pir Panjal ranges. And these are all in Himalayas. So this just to your idea that what we are diverse India is having and what different types of habitats are in India and where we will go and search for the diversity of fauna or flora. So not even a similar place that human left, that they had not moved and they disturbed that area. So these are in the J&K and how the life is there. Then these are the development, whether it's a dam, whether it's a road network, and how these people are living there in those tough areas. Where the 6 months there is a full snowfall. And now I will take you down towards this is in Uttarakhand. And now we move to the deserts. This is a desert ecosystem. Then is Kerala, then Andaman. This is in Sundarban. How we, the team, we moved and how we collect the data, how we will work in the different habitats. These are some of the pictures of the field from where we will collect the data and problems we will face there. And, it is better to move with the team instead of moving alone. This is in a Smithsonian. That in a training I went in 2016. I was trained by the experts there. Mammals, these are some of the camera trap clicks taken by me. This is Alan David from Smithsonian Museum. His expert, this is Christopher Hagen, who discovered the new species after 35 years of carnivore in America. So we are putting the traps. And these are in the fields, we are at, for the salmon traps. And we are, this is, we are monitoring the movement of deer and how we will, this is how in the Sundarbans people are living. Now I will come to just to the mammals again. So as I told you that from all over the world, 27 orders of mammals so far described. And in that, India, we are having only 12 order species representative. So these are the 27 orders. So I will move you order Monotremata. If you see, these are the Kidna and all, they have come into this order. And this is second order. These orders, there is not even a single species recorded from India. Order Didelia Philomorphia. Another order. In that also, we are not a, even a single species, order Fusidiferculata. And this order also, order Microbiotheria. Just for your information, I taken these, Notoricetimorphia. This is the fifth order. Also, we are not having a representative from India. Order Basuromorphia, no representative from India. Seventh order, there is no representative from India. Eighth order, there is no representative from India. Order Aprosoricida, there is no representative from India. Macrociliidae, no representative from India. So if you see this specimen is black and rufous elephant shrew. If you see the trunk type structure there. Then Tubuli dentata, we are not representative from India. Then order Hyrasoidea, is no representative from India. Now the order Proboscidea, in which elephants, even the African elephants and the woolly mammoth earlier, those who are extinct, they come under this order. So this is the Asian elephant. Now this is the fourth order, order Cingulata. There is no representative from India. Another order, Pilosa, no representative from India. Dermoptera, no representative from India. Primates, we are having 33 species, and these are the other species in the other parts of the world. These are primates, the species belongs to India. Lorches, old world monkey, gibbons, we are having only holub gibbon in India. We are not having chimpanzees. This is a cap langur. These are all in primates, animal langurs. These are golden langurs. These are the sparse leaf monkey, is a rhesus macaque, is a bonnet macaque, is a pig-tailed macaque, crab eating macaque. And also we are making a document in which we are making these types of information of all the parts of animals. As you know that we are having in Geological Survey of India from 1850 the collections of animals around more than 270 or 80 species specimens we are having in our National Geological Collection at headquarters and different regional centers. So these types of document also we are making, because every month we are receiving so many material. Those we got from the forest department, they got the poachers and all, and we identify, and Dr. Jarasa is the authority who will submit the report, and the scientist they will do identification and all. This is another order, Rodentia, in which we are having more than 100 species recorded from India. In that Rodentia, skulls, mice, New World rodents, porcupines, all comes into this order. So these are some of the runs from India. So then Lagomorpha, also we are having pikas and hares and rabbits. Then this order, they formed Lipotyphala, in which they made two suborder, Iranosiomorpha, which was earlier a order. So now they clubbed this into Lipotyphala. And this is another Soricomorpha, which is also merged in this 20th order, Lipotyphala. So this is Hazok. These are the Hazok from India. And another order is the Scandidia. And these are the representative of Madras tissue, and these from India. And like that, I told you, we documented all the species. And then the Chiroptera, we are having the maximum number of species, even in the world also. So these are the Chiropterans in India. We are having old world fruit bats, old fruit bats, old world leaf nose bats, false vampire bats. So just some of the clicks of the field and the specimens. Then another order is Polydota, in which pangolin comes. So as Dr. Neil told that I represent in CITES, in which the decision is taken that these all the pangolins, they will, from the appendix 2, they moved into the appendix 1. So more protection is given to them because they are in more in trade. These more the species, Chinese and Indian pangolin, they are more in trade till now. Then another order is order Carnivora. Carnivora, you will find these bears and cheetah, which is extinct from India, hyena, jackal, and all comes into the order Carnivora. So civets, mongoose, hyena, foxes. So this is a cheetah which is extinct from India. This is a cheetah specimen in our Geological Survey of India. The fastest animal in the world. This is a skeleton of cheetah. This is the skin. And this I taken in USA. Where they are doing the breeding program for these cheetahs. This is a tick lion I taken in the Gujarat. And this tiger I taken in Kana and Ranthambore. And this is a leopard. And we are saying that human-animal conflict and all. Because they are not entering into our area. We entered into their area. So that we are facing the problem this time. Because where they will move when we taken each and every part of encroachment by making buildings, by making development activities, so on. So another species, snow leopard. It's also a camera trap photograph. Then the desert cat. The desert Rajasthan I taken, this is Tibetan wolf, and as wild dog, Martin weasels, bunty roams. I will move fast. You will get panda, sloth bear taken in Kana. This is a brown bear by Professor Deepan Rathore. Mongoose. And another order is Perissodactyla, in which rhino, some these tapirs also comes into this order, that not belongs to India. And this asses, wild asses, they also one in Kutch and another species in Ladakh. So this is one horned rhinoceros which is also killed for this rhino horns, and one horns in the trade market they are selling for 40 lakhs 50 lakhs. They told that it will be used for medicine and all, but due to that they are under threat. So these are the original. And then another 26th order is Artiodactyla. Now the cetaceans, marine dolphins and whales, they also due to phylogenetic and this molecular studies, now this order is also kept in Artiodactyla. Now cetacean is not a separate order, it is under Artiodactyla. In Artiodactyla you will all these pigs, musk deer, deer, cattle, antelope, sheep, goat, all comes into the Artiodactyla order. This is a Indian bison, which is a logo of Geological Survey of India from 1916. This is a wild buffalo. This also the population is very much reduced now. These are cheetah, this black buck, these are chinkara, this is barasinga. We conducted the status survey. Yes, sambar, munta jack, nilgiri tar. I will move ahead because so much to we have to discuss, and time is now only 20 minutes left. So these are, I told all these stations, they are now in this Artiodactyla. So this is by Dr. Gopal Sharma, Ganges River dolphin. So this is order Sirenia, in which only from India one species, sea cow we also say, and dugong, one representative from India. And if you say the endemic species, these are some of the endemic species. Those are in any particular area in a country, not in other any part of the world. So those species we are called endemic species. Also there is a done status survey of so many species, bonnet monkey, which are under threat and all, by the different scientists. So I told you this, this is a scientist, Christopher Hagen, who discovered the species Olungutio. So that is more in coverage by the media. He spent 10 years in the field, and after 35 years in America, one new this carnivore species was discovered by Christopher Hagen. And this is another discovery of new species. So these are some of the new species in the world. The mammals, just I will move just for your idea I given. Now I move to the conservation status of mammals. I told you that from India, we are having 427 species. If you will see the what we are saying, that what government is doing, the government has given protection to around 251 species under Wildlife Protection Act. We are having only act in which we will give punishment to a person. Now we will put a penalty. There is a prison for a person. So that is only we are having a Indian Wildlife Protection Act. In that 251 species of mammals kept in that. Listed there. So killing them or taking any part in your house and all, that is also a crime of killing a animal. So if you IUCN, if you say IUCN data listing, in that 392 species out of 427 species, they are evaluated and they are given the different this protection category. They are categorized. They are in threatened categories, vulnerable and endangered, critical endangered. And some are least concern also, and in the CITES also, in which Convention on International Trade of Endangered Species of Flora and Fauna, in that 146 species of mammals are kept, so that if person is taking them by through air or by
sir, your voice is not audible now, sir.
Anil, now?
Yes, sir. Yes, audible now. Please
okay.
Go ahead.
So I told you that in IUCN red listing, 4 species extinct, 8 species critically endangered, 41 endangered, 46 vulnerable, 27 near threatened, and 266 least concerned. And if we say Indian Wildlife Protection Act, in Schedule 1, 78 species, Schedule 2, 76 species, Schedule 3, 8, Schedule 4, 6, and Schedule 5, 68. And if you will say CITES, Appendix 1, 70, Appendix 2, 55, Appendix 3, 21 species. And these are the regionally extinct. Cheetah is extinct from India. Sumatran rhinoceros is extinct from India. Javan rhinoceros is extinct from India. Bantam is extinct from India. And these are the critically endangered species. If you people will search in IUCN Red Data listing, you will get all these species and their details also and how they categorize these species into these categories. And these are the extinct and threatened species: lion-tailed macaque, Chinese pangolin. And conservation in India, I told you that it is very old. During the Ashoka time also, he given the protection to the wild animals. And then after that, in 1879, the Britishers, they made Elephant Preservation Act. Then Wild World Protection Act in 1887. Then United Providence National Park Act 1937. Then only now the Act, Indian Wildlife Protection Act after the independence, 1972. So it is amended. Till now, it was amended in 1982, 86, 91, 2002, 2006, 2010, 2013. And new things were added, which is required as per the protection point of view. And also the species were categorized. Also, the new species were included in Schedule 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Six schedules are there. So these are the different. Just about the mammals, I told you in Schedule Mammals, these mammals will come into scheduled mammals. These are the scheduled mammals. So this document is published. This document is available on Scheduled Mammals of India. This is the Schedule 2 species. So these are the Schedule 2 species. In this, all dolphins and whales, they come under in Schedule 2 and 2 or 3 in the Schedule 1. So these are with photograph. We published the JADCI had published the document, and it is distributed all over India. And also, I think PDF is also available in Google. This is the Schedule 2, Part 2, mammals. These are. So I will move fast because from there you will get those. These are the Schedule 2, Part 2 mammals. Then Schedule 3 mammals. Then Schedule 4 mammals. The least concerned one. Then Schedule 5 mammals. So all together, these are 251. And if you see by graph, 31% are Schedule 1. Schedule 2, 30%, Schedule 5, 33%. And if you see IUCN, you will get by the extinct, critical endangered, endangered, by how many species, that also is provided here. The graph, if you see like this, CITES. So this are you get also the scientists from Geological Survey of India and from other institutes, they are working in India and abroad. They also, the IUCN is conducting yearly or after 2 years or 4 years, the meetings in which experts, they will come together and they will assess the species. And after assessment for 5-6 months, by checking all the data, by their field studies and all, then document is prepared and that is uploaded in IUCN that list of threatened species in their website. So just about the protected areas, though in India, even why I'm telling this question, we are asked in the to the students during interview also, the people don't know what are protected areas. So we are having 4 categories: national parks, wildlife sanctuary, conservation reserve, community reserves. So then in that also, national parks, in between tiger reserves, some area related to tiger population there, elephant reserve, biosphere reserves. So this, if you say the protected area, as per WA is maintaining that database till 870. Protected area we are having in that national park is 104, wildlife sanctuary 551, conservation 88, community reserve 127, and biosphere reserve 18, tiger reserve 50. So this, if you see in this map, the dots, you will find out where these national parks and sanctuaries and biosphere reserves are there in the dot. If you see in our country, other places, the government of India had declared those areas. So whatever the habitat and fauna left or flora left, those area to be protected for the next future generation and for also the for the wealth of for India. So these are the growth of national parks. If you see in 1970, 5 national parks, and now if you see more than 100. So also the if you see in 1970 there is 62 wildlife sanctuary and now it crossed 515, and the proposals are still processed for more than 200. Centuries, and this is prepared by Wildlife Institute of India, and these are provided to us by Professor B.P. Unnial sir. These are the growth of protected areas in India. So now 817, and as proposal moves, So more area to be taken into the protected area network. So this is also showing now, earlier in 88 you see only 3 point something, and now we are having 5.02% in that. And if you see move ahead, in 50 tigers we are having 32 elephant jaw, 18 biosphere, 27 Ramsar wetland site, 18 UNESCO World Heritage site, 107 important coastal and marine biodiversity, 467 important bird area, 531 key biodiversity area. So any type of question will be asked by from you in the interview which you will face. So I am giving this idea that you people will move ahead and search those data, and which is freely available. Our time, it is difficult to get a books and all, and now all the information available, just you have to explore. These are the different acts I told you earlier, in which there is a protection to the flora and fauna. These are the tiger reserve, Ramsar convention, what is any type of question will be. So if you say about conservation, if you see the in Taiwan and Thailand and these areas, people are wearing during the marriage and during the festival these types of dresses, and also these parts, they are on sale, open sale, they are selling the skins and all. So then people moved to the Dalai Lama and they requested, sir, you give one statement that killing of animals and using their product, it is not a humanity. So by his single birds and all, people burned those one, and there is some little bit conservation initiative is there. And we say in a country, we are having now 400 species, if we will save them. And as you know that all these are connected with our religion and all, we worship these all animals. And so that's why also the in India, the species were protected, and only the some poachers, they are there, which they are killing those animals and all. And also JSI, we are doing the identification of the seized material. These are of elephant tusk and all, which are seized. People are killed, poachers, and they are caught by the forest department or in the airport and all. And they will send us for identification. And these are the some fake, this by the camel bone they made tusk, and they are also selling these in 10 lakhs or 20 lakhs. So these are the leopards, even the mongoose. You see, when I was in headquarter, or even in here in Dehradun, so people were caught with the room full of these mongoose here. So you will understand for making these brushes. So government banned now the plastics they are using, but still this is going on. One room full of these brushes, you understand how many they killed, 5 lakhs or 10 lakhs mongoose in the field. And these are the panther. These are the fake skins. The person caught in the airport, he made the color and all. And these are the fake nails. These are original rhino horns, and these are the fake rhino horns. They mixed with the original, the fake one also. And these are the pangolins scales. These are also the fake skins. This is also the fake, the plastic they made. They told it is made of elephant tusk, part of elephant tusk. These are teeth also. It is a sale for 1 lakh rupees or 2 lakhs rupees in the online market. The Wildlife Crime Control Bureau, people, they caught person with this half teeth, and they sent us for identification, and we examined the specimen, and then we given the report that it belongs to the tiger. Just then I will move that why these museums were made all over the world. The museum were made just to spread the knowledge, awareness, because if you even move in the field also, you will get a glimpse of 5 or 10 animals. And for the conservation of point of view, this museum were created. This is a Smithsonian Museum, in the biggest natural history museum in USA, Washington DC. So these are the glimpses when you people visit. This is another natural history museum in London. So here they are also, they kept the Indian specimens also, which they taken before independence. But they kept it very nicely, and they kept all over India, all over the world material there. So just you look on that, in a rooms full of that, this hanging. Even Dr. Anil Mahapatra also for display he made. This is another museum, Chhatrapati Museum at Mumbai. These are some of the pictures. This is another department of government of Ministry of Environment, Forest, Natural History Museum. So this is the museum which I developed at headquarter, Mammoth Gallery, another in Indian museum which was established in 1814. There is also geological surveys having six galleries. So in that one gallery, our team of Geological Survey of India, or mammal section under supervision of Director Geological Survey of India earlier, Dr. K. Venkataraman, and the present director, Dr. Kailash Chandra. So this is the old look of the gallery. And now that was totally dismantled, and in a like a Smithsonian, we developed this one, and this is the new look of that gallery, which is inaugurated last year by our honorable minister. And this is a museum now in Geological Survey of India Northern Regional Center. So where they also we are doing now the changes and new innovative display we are including. And for Government of India also is doing for awareness, Biodiversity Express. It's moving all over a country every year. So this year it is due to this COVID-19, it is now moving, in which all the coaches, they are with display of desert ecosystem and mountain ecosystem with animals and all. So also we are giving training to this frontline staff. And also this is our participation as a Government of India representative in CITES, in which the decision were taken to give the protection and conservation issues were discussed. This is at South Africa Zonesworks. I attended a meeting with the delegates from the ministry. And one, this is in the Israel. And just you see, during the COVID, this is more, these pictures are in the newspapers and media. So the animals are moving when the people be moved inside. So because they are moving on their own land, they are not moving, they are not entered into our place. They are moving to their own place. This is some of the clicks. And for the students, we are having a checklist of Mammal of India with the distribution conservation status. All these 427 species. The document is freely uploaded in Google search. So you will get this book. I told you these are the another books of the mammals by Geological Survey of India. Another book, Fauna Diversity of Indian Himalaya by Dr. Kailash Chandra et al. So it is published last year. That covers around 30,000 species. These are some books of mammals which were released during 100-year celebration in 2016. And these, you see, these are the books now, current books, the mammals of the world. This, the team from the USA and all over the world, the scientists, they first designed the first cover page of belongs to different order. And then they started working. After 10, 20, 20, 30, 30 years, they compiled all the information, and these books comes now into the market. This is the mammal of the world, hoofed mammal, it covers. This is the mammal of the world, primates, all belongs to all over India. Then this mammals of the world, sea mammals, mammals of the world, marsupials, mammals of the world, Lagomorpha rodentia. So they cover all, what are the species in the world so far discovered and recorded. They made separate books, more than 4,000 pages, and with all the illustration, like you see the illustration. And these are the publication of JSA, some of the publication. These are also freely available in Google searchable database. So you will just put the name of books and with the area. So you will get the books freely, which are earlier 2,000 rupees, 1,000 rupees. On the 100-year celebration, that these are given in a public domain. So if you search the in Fauna of India, you will get all these books, 2,000, 3,000 books of 100, 200 years work of JSA. It's there. So these are on our conservation facts handbooks, pictorial handbooks. So this is the site you will visit, faunaofindia.nec.in. These are some of the field tricks. If we lose everything, then we will create artificially these types of that. And if we cut the tree, one day we will be also cut down. And then we will search for the biodiversity carpet and all. By this COVID, we got the lesson that there is a you see, within 4 months, there we understand that we are coming and moving with vehicles and car and this and that. For last 5-6 months, we have not moved. This, our climate is clean, and also we taken those things serious, that to how to safeguard ourselves, because it comes to now us. Now we are suffering, so that's why we are starting understanding ki how we have to wear the mask and we have to follow the guidelines and all. But if we will do development, and with that also we will take care of that, how to nature will also be us, so that the future generation, they will get benefited. So this is Amartha. This just I saw that how rich we are in India. So diversity, you people will see. It's unimaginable. I visited so many countries in the world, but in India we are having even in a single state you will get a different types. The culture and the lifestyle is changed. Food habit is changed. So this, as in this International Day of Biodiversity, the one message which is the slogan: our solutions are in nature. Emphasis, hope, solidarity, and the importance of working together at all levels to build a future of life in harmony with nature. So with this, I thank you, all of you, for listening me. And my purpose is just to give you all a little bit idea that what I had learned so far from other experts. And with this, I thanks Dr. Mahapatra and his team. And I especially thanks to our Director of Geological Survey of India, Dr. Kailash Chandra sir, who given us permission to conduct these types of webinar, even not in a one regional center, all regional center, even in the headquarters, even in the universities, in the banner of JSI. That only happened because the students, they are suffering now, and it is our duty that as a government servant, we have to spread the knowledge, pass on the knowledge, because only those, you are the future, the students, those who are attending. So they will, if you get a little bit from any talk, if they will understand that sun is the source of energy to which in all the living organism. So that line is enough to understand the life. And I hope that you all will be little bit benefited, and you will other things you will search, all things on the mammal are available. And if you having any doubt, you send us emails, we will give you a reply, we will provide you the information. With this, I thanks. Thank you so much.
Sir, thank you very much. Now the topic is open for discussion. If any participant is having any question for Dr. Sarma, please go ahead and you can directly interact. Our purpose of this forum is to interact with the expert, not the talk. The interaction should be given much important. So please go ahead. If you have any question or any work-related problems, you can discuss with your expert. Please go ahead.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon. I am Krishnakant Bakshi from Bhavnagar, Gujarat, sir. Sir, there are so many anthropogenic pressure and threats in India. So most probably, sir, which anthropogenic pressure or threats are more affect the diversity and distribution of mammalian life, sir?
Mammalian, if you are had moved in the field, you will understand that mammals you will not get easily in the field. To single, if you look on the tiger also, if you visit, take a 20 visit or 30 years, then you will get a glimpse of a tiger and all. And till as the development activities, the roads, connectivity, and this oil mining and this mining, other things that are going on. And we are saying that in Rajasthan and Gujarat, I was there for 4 years in Jodhpur. So I moved to all the places of Rajasthan and Jodhpur, Rajasthan and Gujarat. And people says that those areas are totally empty, there is nothing. But there you will, if you search, you will get this desert fox, which is not available anywhere in the other parts. So they are important. What we are saying, that we are by seeing that area empty, they are given for the development activities and all. Even the minings are going on like anything. And these are our mammals and all. They die, if you get some, they die. And even the plants is given. Even we also moved there, this area has to cover so the animal will not move, corridors and all that we were suggested when the proposal were passed. But beside that, if you look on that, the government, I told you in 1970 only 5 national parks, and now you see 104 national parks, even centuries now 515. So still government is doing efforts. What are the pockets? What are the areas? Whether there are 10 species or 12 species, they made it a protected area. Because we are not leaving those areas. For our fun and all, we are moving there. And with our that, the animal will move. If we see in a field any mammal, or other birds and all, if start clicking photo and 20 people, then the animal will move to the other place. So then when if the animal moves to the cities and all, people start killing. It has happened with the leopard and all, you know, the incident so much. Even snow leopard is also targeted because it's taking out these cattle and goats in the hills.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
Sir, thank good you, evening, sir. You. Hello, sir. Good evening, sir.
Welcome. Welcome.
Okay, sir. Yes. So nice presentation. I have three queries. The first one, see, what about the pygmy hawk population in Manas? Present pygmy hawk population. Then the third one is that there was a reintroduction program of pygmy hawk. What is the current status? It is successful. The next one say the Indian elephant is considered, especially the Asian elephants are considered. See, the sex ratio is landed. So what about the proportion of macanas in Indian forest?
First, that pygmy, for pygmy hawk, there is a program going on that even they in the this forest, they made a separate corridor for their breeding and all. So the success is not that much, but because we will not force animal that they will multiply for their activities and all, they need move to the separate hides and caves and this other areas. So if we will keep them in some areas and we think they will multiply, so the steps are going on. More some of the NGOs, they are working on that, even the forest department, they are working on that. And third question, I had not listened clearly, you can repeat now again.
So what are the sex ratio of the Asian elephants? It is landed, no, unequal sex ratio. Okay. Then what about the proportion of macanas in Indian forest?
That we had not worked on that because I think Wildlife Institute is working on those issues. We are working, we are, as a JDSI, we are exploring the area. We have taken one sanctuary or national parks, and that we will cover all the groups, whether it is a butterfly, whether it is a colibri, whether it is a mammal, whether it is a birds. So we will only record, we will identify that what are the total number of species. This sex ratios and their increase in population, that counting we will do. But that breeding programs and that JDSI is not doing. That is the Wildlife Institute of India is designated for that work. So even some scientists of India, JDSI, they are also submitted some projects. So, but till today, we are not working on those areas, breedings and all.
Oh, sir. Good evening, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah, welcome.
Sir, good evening, sir.
Yes, yes.
Hello.
Yes,
sir.
Hello.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Yes, sir.
Go.
Sir, Hindi mein pooch lijiye.
We have a main ground for the mammals mein left. Sir, leopards ki books kahan pe available ho sakti? Kahan pe hame mil sakti hai leopard? Jaisa aapne bataya, jaise all animals. Hello.
थोड़ी आवाज कट रही है लेपर्ड बताइए
सर लेपर्ड की जो बुक्स है वो हमें कहाँ मिल सकती है उसकी जानकारी हमें जानकारी पूरी कहाँ मिल सकती है
आप गूगल आप गूगल में डालिए लेपर्ड्स पे मोर देन 400-500 बुक्स है लेपर्ड एंड प्रे सिंपल लेपर्ड्स के ऊपर भी इवन आपके दुधवा और इनके ऊपर ही 10-15 बुक्स तो दुधवा में ही लेपर्ड के ऊपर है इवन एक लेपर्ड की बुक आपके राजस्थान से सुरेंद्र डॉक्टर सुरेंद्र जी हैं वो आरटी ऑफिस में है वो ट्रांसपोर्ट में उन्होंने एक जितने भी लेपर्ड की वहां पे डिफरेंट यानी कि मोर देन 100 लेपर्ड्स की उन्होंने अलग अलग पिक्चर लेके एक बहुत ही अच्छी बुक निकाली हुई है लेपर्ड्स पे सुरेंद्र चौहान जी हैं अगर आप फेसबुक में भी सर्च करें या गूगल में भी तो उन्होंने लेपर्ड्स पे एक बहुत अच्छी बुक निकाली हुई है
सर आई मीन सर थैंक यू और सर क्या ये आपकी पीपीडी सर एक्चुअली हिंदी में कभी हो सकती है टाइम मिले सर नेक्स्ट टाइम
हिंदी में भी हो सकती है आप देखिए मैंने आपको ये आइडिया इसीलिए दिया जितनी भी इंफॉर्मेशन देखो मैंने भी आप लोगों के लिए मैंने वर्ल्ड के मेरे पास वो डाटा नहीं था पहले तो मैंने आप लोगों की इंफॉर्मेशन के लिए जो 15 ऑर्डर हैं जो कि इंडिया में है ही नहीं मान लो कोई अमेरिका में है वो वाले स्पेसिमन कोई दूसरी कंट्री में है, तो मैंने वो आपको आइडिया देने के लिए मैंने सारा गूगल उसमें वो सर्च किया। बाकी जो इंडियन स्पीसीज का तो हम लोगों का खुद का काम किया हुआ डॉक्यूमेंट था, बट जो वर्ल्ड के लिए तो आप लोगों को अभी इतना अच्छा टाइम आ गया है कि आप लोग गूगल में डालोगे कोई भी इंफॉर्मेशन आपके दिमाग में कुछ आ रहा है हिंदी इंग्लिश में, वो पूरा हिंदी में भी आ जाएगा इंग्लिश में भी आ जाएगा। ठीक है, मैंने कोई आपको जो प्रेजेंटेशन भी दिखाई है, जो प्रेजेंटेशन भी मैंने आपको दिखाई है वो भी मैंने एक जनरल प्रेजेंटेशन दिखाई है, साइंटिफिकली नहीं दिखाई है, कि आपको आइडिया हो कि हम कितने रिच हैं इंडिया में, हमारे पास किसी चीज की कमी नहीं है। यानी कि आप कोई भी इकोसिस्टम ले लें, रिवर्स ले लें, लेक्स ले लें, कुछ भी एनिमल्स में भी ले लिए, 427 स्पीसीज मैमल्स की हैं, मोर देन 1500 स्पीसीज बर्ड्स की हैं, बटरफ्लाईज की मोर देन 1500 स्पीसीज हैं, आपकी मोथ्स की 15,000 स्पीसीज हैं, तो भी 1,00,000 स्पीसीज का डाटा हमारे पास इंडिया में अभी रिकॉर्डेड है। आप सोचो कि बाकी जो कंट्री है उनमें तो 50 स्पीसीज नहीं है किसी कंट्री में, सारी आपकी मिला के बटरफ्लाई इंसेक्ट और सारा कुछ मिला के, तो यानी आप सोचिए 200 कंट्रीज में सिर्फ 6% हमारी फोना डाइवर्सिटी है, उसके बावजूद भी हम लोग 17 मेगा बायोडाइवर्सिटी कंट्री में आ रहे हैं। यानी कि दूसरी जो 17-20-22 कंट्रियों के सिवाय बाकी कंट्रियों की 1%-2% भी नहीं है फोना डाइवर्सिटी और फ्लोरा डाइवर्सिटी।
जी बिल्कुल सर, वो तो सही है सर, पर सर एक्चुअली मैं आपकी जो पीपीटी सर एक बार सिर्फ हिंदी में विस्तार रूप से आप हमें कभी बता पाए टाइम, नेक्स्ट टाइम
बता देंगे आप जो है फीडबैक में वो भेज दीजिएगा अपना रिप्लाई, तो हम आपके लिए प्रबंध करेंगे, फिर लेक्चर रखेंगे, ये तो सीरीज चलती जाएगी अब।
थैंक यू वेरी मच सर, थैंक यू
सर, गुड आफ्टरनून सर,
थैंक यू डियर। हाँ जी हेमंत जी,
हेलो,
अच्छा सस बात हाँ बताइए।
हाँ गुड आफ्टरनून सर, सर एक बड़ा सा जंगल में कोई एक एनिमल का वो मतलब ढूंढने का प्रोसीड्यूर क्या है, मतलब कितने एनिमल है उस जंगल में, तो एक लार्ज नेशनल पार्क में आप कैसे काउंट करते हो, उसका प्रोसीड्यूर क्या है सर? ये
नेशनल पार्क
है कि एक एनिमल दो बार काउंट हो जाए तो उसका चांस क्या होता?
नहीं, उसके लिए हम लोग जो है ना, जो फॉरेस्ट के लोग भी रहते हैं, फॉरेस्ट के लोग तो वहां पे 24 आवर्स मूव करते हैं, गार्ड और ये रेंजर्स वगैरह, तो जब भी हम सर्वे प्रपोज करते हैं तो हम लोग फॉरेस्ट वालों से भी डाटा लेते हैं और जो हमारे पहले के लोगों ने रिसर्चर्स ने काम किया होता है वहां पे उनकी भी इंफॉर्मेशन हम लोग लेते हैं, फिर हम वहाँ फॉरेस्ट में एंटर होके हमें वहां पे भी ये पता होता है कि इस पैच में टाइगर मूवमेंट है, क्योंकि वो कोर एरिया बफर एरिया डिक्लेयर किया होता है, वहां पे कोर एरिया में लोगों को जाने की गाड़ियां भी जाने की परमिशन नहीं होती है, तो वो उन एरिया को तो हम लोग अगर हमारे पास परमिशन होती है तो हम लोग फॉरेस्ट वालों के साथ जाके वहां पे काउंट कर लेते हैं, टाइगर जो आएगा जो वाटर होल्स बना रखे होते हैं वहां पे पानी पीने के लिए आते हैं, तो जब वो सेंसिस करते हैं एवरी ईयर टाइगर है किसी भी स्पीसीज की, तो उसके लिए पर्टिकुलर एक टाइम होता है, तो 5-7 दिन जो है यानी कि 100-150 लोगों की टीम टुकड़े टुकड़े में 10-10 लोगों की पूरे उस जंगल में फैल जाती है, तो हाइड होके बैठ जाते हैं कोई पेड़ के ऊपर कोई झोपड़ ऐसा बना के हाइड प्लेस, तो फिर वो काउंट करते हैं 7-8 दिन, उसके बाद वो जो डाटा आता है फिर उसमें फोटोग्राफी आपके कैमरा ट्रैप्स भी लगे होते हैं जिसमें पता चल जाता है कि भाई ये वाला टाइगर ये स्ट्रिप वाला टाइगर इधर है, वो दूसरा इधर है, ये दूसरी स्पीसीज यहाँ है, तो फिर लास्ट में वो डाटा मर्ज करके उसका स्टेटस आ जाता है।
अच्छा थैंक यू सर,
ठीक है ओके। संजय जी हैं इधर, संजय जी दिख रहे हैं, संजय सिंह टाइगर रॉर जी जी।
हेलो सर, हाउ आर यू?
फाइन फाइन डियर फाइन।
But you had, I don't want to ask a question, but you had poked me to ask a question actually.
Tiger roar आ रहा है आपके उसमें, tiger तो बोलेगा किसका आएगा निकल के।
Sir, you had mentioned 3 times in this your lecture that we are encroaching the habitat of the tiger or habitat of the wild animal. But nowadays, the wild animal had changed his behavior in on the cognition's ground. As you know very well, in our Uttarakhand, that leopards are continuously coming in the villages.
Yes.
So what do you think about it? That is there any conservation strategies? So the this leopard is encroaching the human anthropogenic stresses areas. So would you have, JDSI have any you know plan or any the workshop or any kind of you know the
okay
what you call the working plan for it that we can work on the cognitions behavior of this leopard, or what kind of things we have? My one question. Second question, sir, do you feel any political disturbance, or you can say that any political disturbance in your work while you are working with the this type of schedule one animals? Mm-hmm. That means the procrastination in permission, or you are getting the permission, something like that, because I am facing the same things from the many years, the permission and all those things, sir.
संजीव जी, ऐसा है कि जो आपने पहले बोला कि जो लैपर्ड मूव कर रहे हैं विलेज में आ रहे हैं गोट्स के लिए, तो जैसा ही मैंने आपको जैसे बताया कि हम लोगों का वर्क है कि एरिया एक्सप्लोर करना और वहां पे कितना फौना आपका है उस एरिया में, उसको एक्सप्लोर करके हम उसको डॉक्यूमेंट की शेप में ले आते हैं, और कहीं पे अगर ऐसी इंफॉर्मेशन होती है जहां पे मूव कर रहा है तो फॉरेस्ट वालों के पास उसकी इंफॉर्मेशन होती है, तो फॉरेस्ट वालों का ही वो वहां पे प्लान होता है, और उन्हीं के अगर किसी की वो गोट को ले जाता है तो फॉरेस्ट वाले जो हैं वही उसको ट्रैंकुलाइज करना, और उनको जो आपको जो लोग हैं इन्फेक्टेड जिसकी वो ले गया उनको खर्जाना देना, वो फॉरेस्ट डिपार्टमेंट देता है। दूसरा मैं बता रहा हूँ आपको, मैं बता रहा हूँ, दूसरा जो इसे जो काम कर रहा है वो वाइल्ड लाइफ इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंडिया की भाई ह्यूमन एनिमल कन्फ्लिक्ट, और वो तीसरा जो अभी जो हमारे नई रिक्रूटमेंट्स भी हुई हैं, तो अभी हम लोगों के लॉन्ग टर्म मॉनिटरिंग प्रोग्राम चल रहे हैं जो 10-10 साल के, वो भी मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट एंड फॉरेस्ट की फंडिंग से, तो उसमें जो हमारे साइंटिस्ट हैं वो लोग की यही चीजें कि भाई कहीं जो फॉरेस्ट फायर से कितना नुकसान हो रहा है किसी एरिया में फौना फ्लोरा को, और आपके जो ऐसे मैन एनिमल कंफ्लिक्ट है, पर जो कंट्रोल की वो है फॉरेस्ट डिपार्टमेंट ही कंट्रोलिंग, इवन WI भी जो काम करेगी, जो हम लोग रिकमेंडेशन दे सकते हैं वो करेगा, वहां पे जो ग्राउंड पे जो है फ्रेश डिपार्टमेंट है, उस गांव का प्रधान है, उस गांव का कि लोगों को मना करता है कि भाई ऊपर नहीं जाना है नीचे जाना है, तो वो चलता आ रहा है, वो एक तालमेल बना हुआ है। अगर आपने एक मूवी देखी होगी नेशनल ज्योग्राफी में, जिसमें एक हमारे इंडिया का ही लड़का नागपुर का प्रसन्नजीत यादव है, अगर उसकी आप देखेंगे तो वो उन लोगों के साथ चरवाहों के साथ मूव किया महाराष्ट्र से, तो चरवाहों के साथ चलते चलते उन्होंने नाइट विजन कैमरे यूज किए हुए हैं, तो जब वो कहीं रात पे रुकते थे तो वो पूरा चरवाहे जो थे उसके बॉर्डर को कवर कर देते थे उससे शील्ड से कि भाई अंदर जैकल और आपका हायना और लैपर्ड उनको बकरियों को नहीं नुकसान पहुंचाए। पर उसमें क्या होता था कि रोज तब भी एक दो बकरियों को जंप मार के जब उन्होंने थर्मल कैमराज में देखा उसकी वीडियो रिकॉर्डिंग, और वो चरवाहे भी बैठे रहते थे, जब आ जाता था वो कोई गोली गोली नहीं चलाते थे, चाहे लैपर्ड आ गया चाहे आपका हायना आ गया तो वो जंप मार के अंदर से बकरी उठा के और ले गया, तो अगले दिन उन्होंने उससे इंटरव्यू किया चरवाहे से कि भैया ये तो तुम्हारे बोला जी वो उनका हिस्सा है, ठीक है वो उनका हिस्सा है और ये हमारा तालमेल ये बना हुआ है, अभी यहाँ ये है अगले जाएंगे 100 किलोमीटर 50 किलोमीटर आगे जहां रुकेंगे वहां पे दूसरा टाइगर आएगा लैपर्ड आएगा ये आएगा, तो एक वो तालमेल तो एक बना हुआ है। पर वो है कि जो लोग कह रहे हैं कि वो जहर डाल देते हैं बकरी में और उसको वो है, तो उससे वो थ्रेट बढ़ रहा है, और ऊपर जो आपके हैबिटेट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से मैं ये नहीं बोल रहा हूँ कि कम हो रहा है, गवर्नमेंट ने जितना भी इनिशिएटिव है जो आप मान लीजिए जो नेशनल पार्क हो रही थे उसका एरिया बढ़ता जा रहा है, जो भी पॉकेट्स थे वो नेशनल पार्क सेंचुरीज अब तो कम्युनिटी रिजर्व वो कंजर्वेशन रिजर्व इंडिया में कंसेप्ट नहीं थे, वो भी गवर्नमेंट ने बना दिए जहाँ पे कम्युनिटी किसी एरिया को वो कर रही है, जैसे राजस्थान में एक जगह लोग जो है आपके क्विंटलो जो है ये जो राशन का सामान रख देते हैं और वो जो माइग्रेटरी बर्ड्स आती हैं पूरा 4-5 महीने उनको डालते रहती हैं डैमसिल क्रेन वगैरह, तो वो कम्युनिटी रिजर्व डिक्लेयर कर दिए हैं गवर्नमेंट ने कि भाई उस बहाने से वो बच रही हैं, जैसे पहले हमारे यहाँ सारस क्रेन और उनकी मूवमेंट्स ज्यादा थी तो वो भी कम होते चले गए, कहीं बार्टर कम हो गया जहाँ पे माइग्रेटरी बर्ड्स आ रहे थे वो दूसरी जगह मूव करना शुरू हो गए, तो वो जो है वो स्टडीज पूरे उसमें चली हुई। आपने भी काफी काम किया आप फील्ड में, मेरा आपको उसके ऊपर आपको सारी चीजें मालूम है, और आपने पॉलिटिकल डिस्टरबेंस की बात की, एज ZSI में हमें पॉलिटिकल डिस्टरबेंस काम में कभी नहीं होती क्योंकि हम मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट से हैं और हमें परमिशन दी होती है, और जो हमारा जो फील्ड में हमारा ब्रीडिंग और वो काम है ही नहीं कि हम ट्रैंकुलाइज कर रहे हैं हमने यहाँ से एनिमल्स को दूसरी जगह शिफ्ट करना है, हमारा काम फील्ड में कौन सा दिख रहा है उसका फोटो ले लिया या छोटा स्पेसिमन जो है उसको कलेक्ट कर लिया, फिर लैब में ला के उसको आइडेंटिफाई किया वो न्यू स्पीसीज है तो वो पेपर पब्लिश कर दिया, तो वो हम लोगों का कि हमारा जो जेडएसआई का मेन पर्पज है कि जो हमारा फोना जो है, जैसे 1 लाख स्पीसीज, 1,01,200 इतनी स्पीसीज हमारी होगी यहाँ भी, तो वो डाटा हमारे पास मेंटेन है, कौन से ग्रुप की क्या है, कौन से ग्रुप की कौन सी थ्रेटन में आ रही है, कौन पे ज्यादा वो देना है, कौन कम हो रही है। तो जो हमारा 150 ईयर्स का अगर आप डाटा देखेंगे अभी फोन ऑफ इंडिया का, जेडएसआई का, तो उसमें कौन कौन सी लोकेलिटी से कौन कौन से एनिमल्स हमें मिले हैं, तो अगर हम अभी वो बनाना शुरू कर दिए हैं हमारे डिजिटल, इसमें कि कहाँ कहाँ से मान लो पहले रिकॉर्ड हुआ है, चीता भी कहाँ कहाँ से रिकॉर्ड हुआ है, टाइगर पहले कहाँ कहाँ था रिस्ट्रिक्टेड होके रह गया, अब जो गवर्नमेंट ने 50 टाइगर रिजर्व बना दिए हैं तो वहां से शिफ्ट करके वहां एरिया शिफ्ट कर दिया, तो उसी हिसाब से वो चल रहा है।
वेरी गुड,
थैंक यू,
थैंक यू, थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू वेरी मच, थैंक यू।
मिलेंगे मिलेंगे, बात करेंगे आराम से।
जी बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, मैं फोन पे बात करता हूँ आपसे,
फोन पे करिए, आइए कभी, बैठते हैं कभी भी, फील्ड में चलेंगे, अभी ये कोविड का वो आ गया टाइम, नहीं तो फील्ड में चलते इकट्ठे, आपका एक्सपीरियंस हम यूज करते।
श्योर, राइट नाउ आई एम इन महाराष्ट्र, अभी मैं महाराष्ट्र में हूँ।
Okay.
और वेरी सून कमिंग इन उत्तराखंड, सो व्हेनेवर यू विल कॉल आई विल बी विद यू एज ए एल्डर ब्रदर।
हमारा तो लॉन्ग टर्म रिलेशन का फंडा है, हम तो लॉन्ग टर्म उसमें विश्वास करते हैं, और
जी, बिल्कुल,
साथ बना रहे लोगों का तो टीम में काम करने का एक अलग ही मजा होता है।
बिल्कुल सर, बिल्कुल बिल्कुल, बहुत अच्छा सर,
थैंक यू सर। अनिल जी कुछ?
जी जी जी, एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस प्लीज गो अहेड।
हेलो सर,
प्लीज।
सर, इंडिया में बहुत सारा रेल रोड्स है जो जंगल के बीच में से जाता है,
okay.
तो सर नॉर्थ बंगाल में और साउथ बंगाल में वो रेल रोड से हाथी का डेथ रेट बहुत सारा बढ़ गया, तो सर इसको कैसे हम लो कर सकते हैं, और साउथ बंगाल में तो ये बहुत सारा प्रॉब्लम है कि हाथी
नहीं, आपका पॉइंट सही है, पर देखिए वहां पे जो उनको गाइडलाइन रेलवे को भी दी होती है मिनिस्ट्री से भी, कि भाई वहां पे उसकी स्पीड कम हो जाती है ट्रेन की, जो 80 की स्पीड में चल रही है, 100 की स्पीड में चल रही है, तो अगर वो प्रोटेक्टेड एरियाज में या नेशनल पार्क्स में या जहां पे एनिमल्स की मूवमेंट है, तो आप देखोगे कि उनको वो उनकी स्पीड कम होती है, यानी 20, 40, 50 की स्पीड में, पर वो क्या कि अगर हाथी कहीं स्ट्रक ही हो जाता है तो आप अगर देखते होंगे कि जो ड्राइवर है ट्रेन का उसको आगे नहीं दिखता है कुछ भी कि वहां पे कौन बैठा हुआ है या कोई चल रहा है, ठीक है, क्योंकि वो गाड़ी कार की तरह तो होता नहीं है, तो वो कई बार हाथी वहां पे हिट हो जाता है, कई बार हाथी क्या है ग्रुप में मूव करते हैं, कई जो आपकी रेलवे ट्रैक है जिस जो कि बिल्कुल जंगल के पास से जा रही है तो पता नहीं चलता कि हाथी निकले भी कि नहीं, तो जैसे ही एकदम से निकल आता है तो वो हिट हो जाता है, तो वो है। अब जो ये चीजें भी जो लोगों की डिमांड पे ही ये रेल की पटरियां डली हुई है, तो उसमें अब जो लोगों को भी देखते हुए और जितना हो सकता है उतना गवर्नमेंट करेगी, अगर मान लो ट्रेनें बंद कर दें तो लोग चिल्लाने शुरू कर देंगे कि भाई हमारे वहाँ से ट्रेन में 10 रुपए लगते हैं और टैक्सी में 500 रुपए लगते हैं, तो उसी हिसाब से चली हुई है लोग। हम वो आया कि हम लोगों को तालमेल बना के चलना है कि डेवलपमेंट भी होती रहे और हमारे एनिमल्स भी बचते रहे और हम लोग भी जो कंजर्वेशन की तरफ ध्यान दें।
सर ये तो हम कर सकते हैं कि एलिफेंट कॉरिडोर में ट्रेन का स्पीड कम दिया जाए, और या फिर कुछ
देखो अगर आपने विजिट किया हो, अगर फील्ड में आपने, जैसे संजीव जी हमारे साथ हैं, उधर गोपाल शर्मा जी हमारे साथ हैं, अनिल जी हैं हमारे साथ, और भी काफी साइंटिस्ट इसमें जुड़े हुए हैं, तो अगर आप उनसे बात करोगे तो अगर आप 15 ईयर्स 10 ईयर्स 20 ईयर्स मूव करोगे जंगल में, वो एलिफेंट कहीं से भी मूव कर सकता है, कहीं से भी। एक तो उनका ट्रैक फिक्स होता है कि इस टाइम आते हैं इस टाइम जाते हैं, पर कई बार किसी होल्स में पानी नहीं है, कहीं वो नहीं है, तो वो फिर दूसरी जगह मूव करना शुरू करे, कई बार वो आपका एग्रीकल्चर फील्ड की वजह से फसल लगती है उस टाइम वो उस ट्रैक को चलना शुरू कर देते हैं, तो वो प्रोडिक्ट नहीं हो पाता, पर फॉरेस्ट डिपार्टमेंट को पूरी हिदायत दी होती है कि भाई आप लोगों ने इवन इलेक्ट्रो फेंसिंग की हुई है, मैं तो काफी आपके बक्सा और उस एरिया में मैंने काम किया हूँ, अलीपुरद्वार और सिलीगुड़ी इस एरिया में, इवन मानस और काजीरंगा में भी मैंने काम किया हुआ है, तो उन एरिया में वो इलेक्ट्रो फेंसिंग भी लगी हुई है, करंट चला होता है वहां पे, पर जो हाथी है उसको रोकना तो आपको पता है कि वो तो पूरा पूरी बिल्डिंग निकाल देता है किसी किसी उसमें, यानी कहीं जो घरों में तोड़ के निकल जाते हैं आगे को, अगर एक बार हाथी किसी गाँव में घुस गया, इवन अगर आप सुंदरबन में हो तो वहां जो रॉयल बंगाल टाइगर है, वो जो झोंपड़ी में रह रहे होते हैं, वो एक झोंपड़ी में एक जंप मार के अंदर से उठा के दूसरी तरफ निकल जाता है, पता भी नहीं चलता कि झोंपड़ी में होल कब हो गया।
अच्छा सर, थैंक यू सर,
थैंक यू।
सुप्रिया गुप्ता आस्क्ड वन क्वेश्चन सर, वेयर फ्रॉम वी गेट द टोटल डिटेल्स अबाउट देसी इंडियन काउज?
कौन सी काउ?
देसी इंडियन काउज।
इंडियन काउ?
या
उसका तो डिपार्टमेंट है एनिमल हस्बेंड्री वाला, जो सेपरेट है उसकी मिनिस्ट्री, वहीं से मिलेगा उसका जो, अगर वाइल्ड, उसकी वाइल्ड की बात करें तो उसका डाटा जेडएसआई दे सकती है, कितनी स्पीसीज है उसकी कैटल्स की जो वाइल्ड है, एज ए वाइल्ड बुफेलो है आपका, बोस बोरस है, तो इन चीजों की हम वाइल्ड की दे सकते हैं, जो एनिमल हस्बेंड्री और इसमें कितनी देसी काउज हैं और कितनी बाहर से ब्रीडिंग की हुई है, तो वो आपको एनिमल हस्बेंड्री डिपार्टमेंट अलग से है, वहां से मिल सकती है।
SD asked one question, what about the studies on Malabar civet cat by JDSI? Any special project on this?
अभी कोई प्रोजेक्ट नहीं चल रहा है, पर मेरे को लगता है कि उसमें 3-4 पेपर हैं, अगर ये सर्च करेंगे गूगल में तो मिलेंगे मालावर सीवट कैट पे, जेडएसआई क्या दूसरे डिपार्टमेंट के भी लोगों ने किसी ने, या WIU में भी किसी स्टूडेंट ने किया होगा डॉक्यूमेंट, तो वो वहां पे मिल सकता है इन्फॉर्मेशन उसकी।
हेमंत सिंह राणा आस्क्ड वन क्वेश्चन, हाउ टू इंट्रोड्यूस द स्पेसिफिक हैबिटेट फॉर ए पर्टिकुलर मामल स्पीसीज?
वो पर्टिकुलर हैबिटेट तो आपका जो इंडेमिक स्पीसीज है हमारी 45 स्पीसीज, वो तो एक पर्टिकुलर हैबिटेट में ही है। मान लो कि कोई स्पीसीज आपके 20 किलोमीटर के एरिया में है, कोई 50 किलोमीटर का उसका मूवमेंट का एरिया है, तो वो दूसरे एरिया में है नहीं, 45 जो स्पीसीज है इंडेमिक। वैसे आप पर्टिकुलर मैमल तो आपको पता है मूविंग है, ये तो प्लांट तो है ही नहीं कि एक जगह खड़ा रहेगा। इवन आप टाइगर अभी पीछे देख रहे होंगे कोविड के टाइम या उससे पहले, एक टाइगर मूव करता हुआ राजस्थान से मूव करता हुआ वहां पहुंच गया आपका नॉर्थ ईस्ट में। तो एनिमल्स का जो मूवमेंट है वो जैसे उसको सुटेबल लगता है तो, या थ्रेट लगता है कहीं पे, तो अपने बचाव के, जानवर तो अपने बचाव के लिए जिंदा रह रहा है, और चारों तरफ से थ्रेट ही है अभी आजकल जानवर को, जाएगा कहाँ पे। अभी जो यही है जो हमारे नेशनल पार्क्स और सेंचुरीज और एरिए हैं, इसमें थोड़ा बहुत प्रोटेक्टेड है एनिमल्स, बाकी अगर बाहर आ जाता है तो लोग सोचते हैं कि ये उनको मार देगा या कुछ हो जाएगा या गाड़ी से हिट हो जाता है हाईवे पे, तो उसमें वो है कि नए कॉरिडोर और वो चल रहे हैं, जितने भी नेशनल हाईवे के प्रोजेक्ट पास होते हैं तो उसको रखते हैं कि रोड से काफी ऊंचा रखते हैं उसको, ताकि एनिमल ऊपर नहीं चढ़े। बड़े एनिमल्स तो क्या, जो छोटे एनिमल्स हैं बड़े तो टाइगर और ये तो दिखते हैं, जो रोडेंट्स हैं, रोडेंट्स की 100 से ज्यादा स्पीसीज हैं चूहे टाइप के छोटे, तो वो तो बेचारे ऐसे ही सरवाइव कर रहे हैं। इवन डेजर्ट जर्विल, अगर डेजर्ट में जाओगे तो वैसे दिखेगी नहीं, दिखने लगेंगी तो 500 दिखेंगी, जैसे आदमी के आधा किलोमीटर की मूवमेंट गाड़ी से उतर के देखने लगा कि कोई चीज देख रही, वो निकलते नहीं फिर बाहर। वो तो मैमल्स पे तो है, जितना ज्यादा ऑब्जर्वेशन करोगे उतना जितना ज्यादा फील्ड में मूवमेंट का चांस मिलेगा, और अपनी सेफ्टी को देखते हुए। इवन टाइगर को ही, मेरे को 20 साल हो गए तो मैंने कोई 15-20 इंसिडेंट में मैंने टाइगर को देखा होगा, और 5-6 इंसिडेंट में होगा जो मैंने उसको सेफ्टी यूज करते हुए मैंने उसकी फोटो ले पाया होगा। अब हम जंगल में ये भी नहीं है कि उसको सीटी मारे, है जी, लोग करने लग पड़ते हैं, अपनी जिप्सियों में भागते हैं आगे से घुमा के पीछे से घुमा के, वो गाइड लोगों पैसे पूछे देखे कि तेरे को बस फोटो खिंचवा दे। तो हम लोगों ने जो जैसे जो रूल्स को फॉलो करते हुए, तो 20-25 इंसिडेंट में 20 सालों में मेरे को 15-20 बार ही टाइगर दिखा है मैंने, जितने भी आज तक 50-60 नेशनल पार्क और सेंचुरीज में मूव किया हूँ। तो क्योंकि जानवर तो अपने हिसाब से मूव करेगा, इवन जो काफी हमने फील्ड की फोटोग्राफ दिखाई, कोई रात को 12 बजे दिखाया, कोई कब दिखाया, तो उसमें उनका मूवमेंट का कोई निश्चित नहीं है कि वो नहा के आया और चलने लग पड़ा सड़क उधर घूमने आ गया जंगल।
Alfred Jamie asked one question, sir, out of 100 only few cases are reported about hunting and poaching in India, mainly in local village area. How can we stop these activities?
वो स्टॉप होगी जब हम अपना माइंडसेट चेंज करेंगे। हमारा माइंडसेट जब तक चेंज नहीं होगा, और अगर आप वाइल्ड लाइफ क्राइम कंट्रोल ब्यूरो की रिपोर्ट्स देख लें तो एक साल में मोर देन 40-50,000 केसेस हैं, जो कि अगर डेली का आप देख लो तो रोज के 10-12 केसेस जो न्यूज़पेपर में होंगे वो होंगे इसके किलिंग के और पोचिंग के, जो कि अखबार में आ जा रहे हैं, और दूसरे हिडन अलग है, क्योंकि जो लोग हैं वो सोच रहे हैं कि इजी मनी मेकिंग है ये प्रोसेस, और पैसा जो है कमाना है, कोई बाहर से आ जाता है कि यार तेरे को 20,000 दे देंगे, टाइगर की स्किन चाहिए, तो लोकल आदमी को तो पता है कि टाइगर का मूव कर रहा है, लेपर्ड का मूव कर रहा है, तो वो 20,000 रुपए के लिए वो कर देता है, वो उसको मार मूर के वो करोड़ों में जाके उसकी एक स्किन बिकती है आगे जाके, और इवन एक एक पार्ट बिकता है, एक दांत ही 5-6 लाख का बिकता है, तो आप अंदाजा लगा सकते हैं बिजनेस। और इंडिया अभी जो है मोर देन 50-70,000 लोगों की एक वो बनी हुई है लिस्ट जो इंडिया में पोचर्स हैं पूरे इंडिया में, तो नेटवर्क फैला हुआ है। तो एक जब संसार चंद नाम का एक वो पोचर पकड़ा गया था वेस्ट बंगाल में, तो उसके एक दिन में अकाउंट में 50-50 लाख रुपए उसके ट्रांसफर हो रहे थे, तो उसने बोला कि भैया बोला अब आप टाइगर नहीं मार रहे, लेपर्ड मार रहे हो, बोलता जी जैसे इंटरनेशनल मार्केट में डिमांड होती है उस हिसाब से हम मारते हैं, बियर की डिमांड होगी तो बियर मारेंगे, 50 स्किन बियर की चाहिए तो पूरे इंडिया में अलग अलग जगह एक 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 करके मारते हैं वो लोग। अच्छा जैसे छोटे उसकी मंगूज की या पेंगोलिन की डिमांड है तो उसी हिसाब से एक जगह में नहीं मारते, वो सारे पूरे इंडिया में जो लोग हैं और एक जगह माल पहुंचता है वहां से फिर आगे डिलीवर होता है, चाहे सी रूट से जाए, चाहे पैदल कोई ट्रैक से मूव करे दूसरी कंट्री को, नेपाल और उसको। तो वो हम लोगों को है कि जो अगर ऐसी कोई एक्टिविटी हमें गाँव में दिखती है तो हम लोग उसकी इन्फॉर्मेशन फ्रेश डिपार्टमेंट को दें, पुलिस को दें, इवन अब गवर्नमेंट ने तो इतना ओपन कर दिया सभी मिनिस्ट्री की वेबसाइट्स में कि आप सीधा वहां पे कंप्लेंट लिख दो तो वहां से सीधा एक्शन होता है वहां पे। अब तो वो चोरी छुपे वाला ड्रामा रहा ही नहीं कि फोन नहीं लग रहा वो नहीं, अब तो मोबाइल से जरा सा मैसेज किया नहीं, एक व्हाट्सएप मैसेज ही आपने अगर मेरे को भेजा तो शाम तक वो लाखों लोगों को पास हो जाता है। तो वो है कि वैसे ही वाइल्ड लाइफ क्राइम कंट्रोल ब्यूरो वालों ने भी सभी गाँव में एक एक आदमी बना रखे हैं, वो टीम बना रखी है, अभी बायोडाइवर्सिटी रजिस्टर के लिए भी वो कमेटीज बनी हुई हैं कि भाई जो ऐसी ऐसी एक्टिविटी में इन्वॉल्व है उन लोगों को उसमें काम दिया गया हुआ कि वो काम छोड़ के भैया देश के लिए वो करो तुम बचाने के लिए। तो जितना हम लोग अपने आप करेंगे वो उतना ही देश में सुधार हो पाएगा, और हम ही लोगों को बचाना है, तीसरा आदमी तो कोई आएगा नहीं बाहर, तो दूसरी कंट्री के पास तो उनको पता नहीं है टाइगर टाइगर होता कैसा है, तो जब वो टाइगर को देखते हैं बोलेंगे इतना मैग्नेटिक जानवर है, या छोटा आपका श्रू देख लिया उसका लग गया, तो वो उनको तो एक म्यूजियम बाहर म्यूजियम को एक स्पेसिमन मिल जाए उसके लिए वो लाखों रुपए देने को तैयार है।
Anandan Shiva from FSI asked one question. Tell me more about marine mammals distribution in BOBP region. Dr. Shiva, we have a special session on marine mammals. So probably Dr. Sharma is an expert of land mammals. So we'll arrange a special session in that. We'll address this particular issue.
So till today, around 33 this marine mammals recorded all from in the seas from India. So that books are there, Marine Mammals of India, so many 10-20 books are there, and lot of information is there, even photographs, lot of photographs were there. So it is up to him to explore, and also as Dr. Anil told that on marine mammals also somebody will give the presentation. Even Gopal Sharma is there, he will give on this dolphin boy of India. He will give a lecture on dolphins and all, how to conserve and how they taken the initiatives and those. So it is a chain of lectures and talks.
Sir, ek information share karna chahta hu.
Ji ji Gopal ji bataiye.
Main dekh raha hu ki hamare kai sare students hain, they are from Bihar only.
Okay.
Un hamesha ek sawal puchte rehte hain ki wildlife ke survey ke liye wildlife ke अंदर में कोई प्रोग्राम करने के लिए कोई JDSI किसी तरह का कोई ट्रेनिंग ऑर्गेनाइज करता है, मिनिस्ट्री ऑर्गेनाइज करता है, तो मैं एडिशन टू दिस इंफॉर्मेशन एक मैं जो शेयर करना चाहता हूं कि डॉल्फिन पर तो मैंने शुरुआत कर दी है अंडर ग्रीन स्किल डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम, और उसमें हर एक साल 30-40 बच्चों को हम लोग ट्रेनिंग दे रहे हैं कि उसका सर्वे कैसे हो, उसका रेस्क्यू कैसे हो, कंजर्वेशन एफर्ट के लिए आम लोगों को क्या करना चाहिए, हमारे बच्चे जो वाइल्ड लाइफ में आना चाहते हैं, JDSI ज्वाइन करना चाहते हैं या इस तरह का ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में जाना चाहते हैं, तो उनको किस तरह से ट्रेनिंग दिया जाए कि वो हमारे लाइन में और हमारे डिपार्टमेंट में और इसी तरह के जो सिमिलर डिपार्टमेंट है उसमें वो जॉब ले सके। तो सर आपसे कुछ और एडिशनल इंफॉर्मेशन दे सकते हैं क्योंकि हमारे बहुत सारे बच्चे हैं जो अभी जुड़े हुए हैं।
गोपाल जी देखिए, जैसे आप भी अभी जिस पोजीशन पे बैठे हुए हैं, अनिल जी भी हैं, हम लोग ऐसा नहीं थी था कि हमें लोग घर पे बैठे हुए तो हम लोगों को सीधे गवर्नमेंट ने जॉब दे दी। हम लोग भी 10-12 साल अलग अलग इंस्टीट्यूट में ICR ICMR आपका IWST ICFRE अलग अलग इंस्टीट्यूटों में हम लोगों ने काम किया, वहां से सीखा लोगों से। जितना हम लोग सीखेंगे और जितना हम लोग एक्सपोजर लेंगे और काम करेंगे और बीच में ब्रेक नहीं करेंगे अपने काम में, तो काम मिलता जाएगा। और काम मिलने में कोई कमी है नहीं इंडिया में। अगर आप इंडिविजुअल भी किसी ने MSc की हुई है, PhD की हुई है, इंडिविजुअल उसको प्रोजेक्ट दे रही है गवर्नमेंट सीधा 50-50 लाख के। इवन अब आप लोग आ रहे हो रिसर्च स्कॉलर, जब हम लोगों के टाइम 2-2 हजार 5-5 हजार रुपये मिलते थे, अब 40-40 45-45 हजार 75-75 हजार रुपये मिल रहे हैं उसमें टेम्परेरी प्रोजेक्ट्स में। और JSI का जो कंसर्न है, ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम सभी रीजनल सेंटर करवा रहे हैं, हेडक्वार्टर करवा रहा है, उसमें जो बच्चे अप्लाई करते हैं उन लोगों को शॉर्ट लिस्ट करके 20 बच्चों को 50 बच्चों को वो ट्रेनिंग दी जाती है। इवन हम लोग इन्फोर्समेंट एजेंसीज हैं उनके लिए भी स्पेशल ट्रेनिंग देते हैं, क्योंकि वो लोग बॉर्डर पे होते हैं तो उनको सांप और ये सभी से पाला पड़ता है, तो कैसे बचना है, कैसे उनको मारना नहीं है, तो उनके लिए भी हम लोग ट्रेनिंग JSI करवाती है। जैसे जैसे रिक्वायरमेंट आती है उस हिसाब से ट्रेनिंग होती है। और बच्चों के लिए हम लोग ये नेशनल सेमिनार, अभी ड्यू टू कोविड ये बंद हो गया, ये तो हम 100-150 बच्चों का तो हर साल सभी रीजनल सेंटर में हम लोग नेशनल सेमिनार्स करवाते थे, जहाँ की बच्चे दूसरे एक्सपर्ट से मिलते थे और 20-25 लोग वहाँ प्रेजेंटेशन देते थे। और किसी के भी आइडिया से, मेन है कि अभी जो बच्चे हैं चाहे बिहार हैं, अभी तो पूरे ऑल ओवर इंडिया से यहाँ जुड़े हुए हैं, कुछ अब्रॉड के भी हैं 4-5, तो उसमें है जितना लर्निंग। जैसे बच्चे अभी सेमिनार्स में जुड़ रहे हैं डेली, तो उनका इंटरेस्ट है कि भाई चाहे उनके कंसर्न का है ही नहीं मैमल, पर वो सुनना चाह रहे हैं कि भाई मैमल्स क्या चीज है। अब तो फ्री में चीज मिल रही है, पहले तो रजिस्ट्रेशन करना पड़ता था। पहले मान लो आज हमने यहाँ फंक्शन करवाया होता, सब लोग यहाँ आते, कहीं से बस से आता, कोई कैसे आता, उसका खर्चा, फिर रुकने का खर्चा, फिर वो बाहर ही घूमता रहता, कोई दोस्त मिल जाते। अभी तो घर में बैठे ही यानी बिना डिस्टरबेंस के सभी को इंटरेक्शन फ्री में वो मिल रही है इंफॉर्मेशन। तो सभी बच्चों से मैं वो रिक्वेस्ट करना चाहूंगा कि भाई उसका फायदा उठाएं, और सभी के ईमेल आईडी हैं, आप उनको करें कंसल्ट, सारी इंफॉर्मेशन गूगल सभी जगह अवेलेबल है, मिनिस्ट्रियों की वेबसाइट में बुक्स की बुक्स दे रखी है। अब इंटरेस्ट पे है, अब मैं और आप उनको जा नहीं सकते किसी को भी।
बिल्कुल, तो अभी हमारे जो भी इस वेबिनार में स्टूडेंट्स हैं और वो चाहते हैं कि ट्रेनिंग का फायदा लें, तो आप JSI का वेबसाइट और मिनिस्ट्री का वेबसाइट हमेशा विजिट करिए, और उसमें हर एक एनिमल ग्रुप के ऊपर आप लोगों के लिए ट्रेनिंग ऑर्गेनाइज किया जाता है, आप अप्लाई कीजिए, और जो भी एक्सपर्ट हैं अलग अलग रीजनल सेंटर में आपको बुला करके ट्रेनिंग देंगे, और वो वर्चुअल नहीं होगा, वो आपको फिजिकली आना होगा, तभी आप ट्रेनिंग ले पाएंगे एंड यू विल बी बेनिफिटेड।
Mr. Krishnamurti, you want to ask some question? No need to take permission. Please go ahead. Yes, either sir, you ask sir. Directly or you can type your question.
Am I audible, sir? Am I audible?
Yes, sir. You are audible. Yes, please go ahead.
Sir, yeah. Good evening, sir.
Good evening, sir. Thank you for the wonderful talk, Gaurav, sir. I want to ask about, we have heard so many cases of electrocutions, right? Okay. So many animals have been dead or hit by the current or electric wires. So they died. So,
okay. But are the animals? Which are the animals?
Sir, elephants हैं, tigers sometimes and times.
नहीं, tiger, elephant. देखिए, जो आप जहाँ पे भी electric वो किया होता है, वो उसमें इतना load दिया ही नहीं होता current का कि animals या आदमी भी, हम लोग भी touch करें तो हम लोग उसमें मर जाएं। हम लोग भी उसमें जो आदमी
जी जी
हाँ, तो उसमें जो current छोड़ा होता है वो बिल्कुल कम load का छोड़ा होता है कि उसको जरा सा लगे वो और वो अपने आप पीछे हट जाए। वो ऐसा 440 वोल्ट वाला नहीं दिया होता है कि भाई एकदम से कोई लगा और वो फंस चिपक गया वहां पे और मर गया। तो वो कई बार क्या होता है जो वो वायरिंग होती है उसमें पांव फंस जाता है, पांव फंस जाता है जानवर का, ठीक है। तो उसमें क्या है कि फिर वो जो पास के जो फ्रेश डिपार्टमेंट या गांव के लोग होते हैं वही पीट के मार देते हैं उनको, ये जो लोकल लोग होते हैं टाइगर टूगर और लैपर्ड के केस। तो जब वो फ्रेश वालों को इन्फॉर्मेशन पहुंचती है तो वो आके उसको जाल फेंक के फिर वो पांव उसका अलग करके फिर कुछ दिन वहां रख के जू में या फिर उसको अगर वो नहीं हुआ होता तो जंगल में छोड़ देते हैं।
Actually, sir, I've heard 2-3 cases of these type of cases in Uttar Pradesh.
Okay.
So it was just a query ki if any measures.
वो है कई बार देखिए जो वहाँ पे on करने वाला switch है, मान लीजिए वो उसने वो उसको connectivity किया नहीं है और वो दूसरे वाले load वाले उसमें लगा दिया या वो defective हो रखा है जिससे कि load आगे कम transfer होता है और उससे पूरा लोड चला जा रहा है करंट का। ये संजीव जी बोलना चाहेंगे इसमें मेरे ख्याल से, संजीव जी कुछ बोलना चाहेंगे? म्यूट है आपका, अनम्यूट कर लीजिए।
या संजीव जी, वेरी श्योर। हां यस, आर यू गेटिंग माय वॉइस?
या यस सर, यस
सर। एक्चुअली योर क्वेश्चन इज वेरी गुड, वेरी वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन रिगार्डिंग द उत्तर प्रदेश। So such type of cases will be happen in all over the India, but the certified fencing is never depicts you such type of shock as Sharma ji had already mentioned to you. It is for the personal purpose actually. Those farmer or the stakeholder are illegally using their electricity for the irrigation purpose or other kind of purposes. So yeah, such type of animal will be die with this type of activities, with type of deeds, not for the any kind of certified fencing and so on. So especially in the case of Uttar Pradesh, not in case of the Uttar Pradesh, some the portion of the central highland of the India like Maharashtra and MP. So we have the same type of cases everywhere all over the India, across the country. So the basic thing is that this is for the personal purpose. Now the basic question is that we have a fragmented relationship with the nature actually. So second thing, we have to make a balance between the animals, what you call, their own private life with intermingled with our private life. So there is no any kind of check all over the world that you will get any kind of check for the movement of the wild animal, because animal, wild animal will only depend upon their own will. But we are the high intellectual person of the society, so this is, we have to be take care about this thing. If there is a wild animal movement is over there, so this is our duty, being a good citizen of India, that we have to be some connectivity with the forest department or the some right authorities. Then you can go through this and tell them that something somewhere wrong and the tiger is moving here or elephant is moving here. So this is totally based upon anthropogenic point of view actually, my dear friend. It is not it is hardly happened, unnaturally happened, yeah, that it will be shocked and electrocuted or it will die. So this is only the things actually, no? But, yeah, but it is not mandatorily, or it is, yeah, not totally different by that. Are you, yeah, I think you got, yeah, my point.
Yeah, yes sir, yes sir, I got your point. Actually I was working in Katarniagat Wildlife Sanctuary this year, okay, in the month of Feb. So some of the villagers told me this story, so I was just wondering, is there any particular measures to solve these problems? So thank you so much
conflict issue. Thank you Krishnamurti. Conflict issue is very benevolent issues nowadays actually.
Yeah, exactly.
So it is just like it is simple. I have one line for you, that it is just like, yeah, a solution of pollution in dilution, and there is no dilution for the solution. So animals are changing their behavior and human is also changing their behavior. It's a simple caption. Exactly. I'm just telling to you. So be, take care and good luck for you, for your conservation strategy and all this. Thank you very much. Thank you Sharma ji.
Thank you Sanjeev ji.
I have taken your time.
Welcome.
Thank you.
One question. He is always fond of new discovery. He is asking, mammalian diversity to oil explode in India. Is there any potential area where we can still get new species?
Hai potential area aapka northeast pura potential hai, even western ghats mein bhi potential hai. Western ghats mein bhi hum log kafi एक्सप्लोर करने पे हम लोगों के, इवन हिमालयस में भी काफी अनटच्ड एरियाज हैं। मेन है अभी मैंने जैसे कि बताया कि क्रिस्टन हैगन जिन्होंने डिस्कवरी की ओंटेगनो की, जो अमेरिकन स्पीसीज आफ्टर 35 इयर्स कार्निवोर अमेरिका से डिस्कवर हुआ, तो उन्होंने 10 इयर्स स्पेंड किए उसमें फील्ड में, क्योंकि मैमल्स में जो मान लो एक माइस है या रैट है या श्रू है, देखने में एक जैसे लगेंगे, तो अगर जब उसके कंटिन्यू स्टडीज करेंगे, उसके हैबिटेट कौन से उसमें रह रहा है, कैसे रह रहा है, उसके बाद अगर हम लोग वो सारा स्टडी करके 10-15 साल और जितने दूसरे उसके रिलेटेड स्पीसीज हैं उनको स्टडी करेंगे, तब जाके उसमें न्यू डिस्कवरी हो पाती है। इंडिया में जैसे पीछे अरुणाचल मकाक की डिस्कवरी हुई थी 10-15 साल पहले, उससे पहले बैट्स की डिस्कवरी हुई है इंडिया में। तो डिस्कवरी मेन है वो फील्ड में हम कितना एक्सप्लोर कर पाते हैं। अभी भी इंडिया जो है अभी भी मेरे ख्याल से 20-25% से ज्यादा हम लोगों ने एक्सप्लोर किया ही नहीं है, तो इतना अभी काफी पोटेंशियल है इंडिया में ही। मेन है कि हम लोग कैसे वो काम करते हैं।
आशीष कुमार दास आस्क्ड वन क्वेश्चन, सर हाउ कैन वी फाइंड हर्बीवोरस एनिमल डेंसिटी बाय यूजिंग कैमरा ट्रैप?
कैमरा ट्रैप्स के लिए तो आप ये नहीं है कि एक दो कैमरा ट्रैप्स लगा दिए और हम लोग उसको उसी डाटा को वो मल्टीप्लाई कर दिया। जब भी कैमरा ट्रैप्स लगते हैं तो पूरा जो आपका नेशनल पार्क से कोई भी स्टडी साइट ली गई है तो उसमें कंटिन्यूसली 100-200 कैमरा ट्रैप्स लगाए जाते हैं, और वो कंटिन्यूसली 1-2 ईयर स्टडी करने के बाद हम लोग उसके बाद वो डिस्टेंस उससे जो आपका स्टैटिस्टिक्स है उसके साथ मेजर करके फिर वो डाटा आएगा, या कभी रिकॉर्ड में आया, जरूरी नहीं है कि वो कैमरा ट्रैप के उसमें वो क्लिक हो गया हर बार। तो पहले तो उसको फील्ड में वैसे ऑब्जर्व करना है कि भाई इस एरिया में उसकी मूवमेंट है, ये ट्रेल वो यूज करता है, उसके बाद वो स्टडी के बाद 5-6 महीने के बाद फिर वो कैमरा ट्रैप्स लगते हैं कि इस साइट पे लगानी है और इस हाइट पे लगानी है, और इट वेरीज स्पीसीज टू स्पीसीज।
अन्वेषा मुखर्जी आस्क्ड व्हाट इज द मिनिमम क्वालिफिकेशन फॉर डूइंग पीएचडी इन ZSI, एनी एक्सपीरियंस और नेट इज मैंडेटरी?
देखिए ZSI पीएचडी करवाता नहीं है, पहली बात पीएचडी अवार्ड होती है यूनिवर्सिटी से। ZSI में कोई भी एनी स्टूडेंट ज्वाइन ZSI इन अ रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट, सो दे विद द अप्रूवल ऑफ डायरेक्टर, विद द परमिशन ऑफ डायरेक्टर जियोलॉजिकल सर्वे ऑफ इंडिया, दे आर परमिटेड टू रजिस्टर टू एनी यूनिवर्सिटी, एंड ZSI दैट सुपरवाइजर विल बी द को गाइड, and the person will do the PhD, and for that ZSI is giving fellowship, and there is a JRF scheme in ZSI every year that is announced. Then for the 5 years we are hiring the students on their selection, and in that 5 years they will do the research work also, and for their own also they will register for PhD. Like that I also done in 2000 in the, I worked in a project in ZSI and I completed my PhD, and after that I moved to IWST, ICFRE, and then ICR, and then again moved back, I selected in ZSI. So that is up to the approach that, but ZSI never gives a degree, ZSI degree or PhD is awarded by the university.
To add sir's answer, I will tell you that now also there is an advertisement of 20 research scholars in ZSI. You can, if you have minimum qualification of MSc, you can apply. And NET gate is not mandatory to enter ZSI, but if NET is there, your fellowship will be higher. That is the condition. And regarding another question, to be a part of training program in ZSI, do we need to be in any national institute? That is not necessary. You can apply for training if your CV finds good and you are working on particular animal on which ZSI imparted training. If there is an application number is more, or if there is application number is less than the required amount of students we want to induct, everyone can be accompanied with that.
Even BSc students, MSc students, PhD students, they are also permitted for training program in ZSI. There is no restriction ki only this is for PhD fellow, this is for MSc fellow, this is, so with the approval of director ZSI, BSc people were also permitted. Even in Green Skill Development Program, those who completed BSc or plus 2 or 10th, so they are also they were also trained in the GSDP training programs, and then they are recruited temporarily or permanently in the JUS or even in the biodiversity boards and all, or in the field in the projects also.
Medha, another student asked probably, how can we do our dissertation in JSI if you wish?
Dissertation for MSc student, if they approach us, that is, they have to do the dissertation in other in the institute. So from their head, they will send the letter to the concerned officer in charge, and if they are at headquarters, from their institute, then the letter has to be sent to Director JSI. And then we, if they are sending to officer in charge, then we also send to our director for the permission. And the scientist in JSI Regional Center, they will train the person for 6 months and they will complete their dissertation. And there is no charge. In JSI, there is no charge. Some institutes, they are charging 30,000, 40,000 for this doing this dissertation work, permitting for dissertation work. But JSI till now, from last 20 years, I am here. And as we are the government of India, and we, there is no charge, not even a single rupee is charged, even for printing and all. Printing and all, student has to do their own, but for guidance and all, there is no charge.
Sir, is it audible?
Yeah, please go ahead.
Sir, is it
hello? Hello?
Is it audible, sir?
Yeah, we can hear you.
I'm Dr. K. Sivachandra Bose, calling from Tamil Nadu. I wanted to ask you one question, sir. Not question, but a clarification. And recently we used to notice that, and most of the marine mammals are being stranded or assured. What is the reason behind that? And how to control this activity, sir?
क्या अनिल जी साउंड थोड़ी कम आ रही है क्या पूछ रहे हैं व्हाट इज आस्किंग
सुनाई नहीं दे रहा
आई एम कॉलिंग फ्रॉम तमिलनाडु
यस यस यू स्पीक लाउडली यू स्पीक लाउडली
रिसेंटली या रिसेंटली
यस यस प्लीज टेल
Nothing is audible, Dr. Shiva Chandra Bose.
You send your
mammals.
Yes. Please tell.
Marine mammals. Assured to. Standard to.
Standard?
Is it audible, sir?
Now yeah, it is audible. You ask the question.
Sir, is it audible?
Yes.
Yes.
You ask your question.
Sir, is it audible?
Or,
yeah, it's audible. Please go ahead.
Or you type in a chat box.
Hello, sir.
You type your question
is
in
it
chat
audible?
Box. Yes, you say. Yes, audible.
Hello.
Please. You ask.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. You also email us if any query. You email to us or whatever the link is provided.
It is not audible to you.
Yeah.
There is some problem.
No problem. You send your question to the to that mobile number. You send your question. Later we will reply.
Hello,
you.
Sir.
Yes. Tell. Ask your question.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Shiva Chandra Bose. We cannot hear you. There might be some problem. You can type your question in the chat box so that sir can, even after the session also, he can answer you. So, sir, we have taken almost all the questions of the participants. And
hello.
Yeah,
sir, Krishnamurthy again, sir. Actually, one last question, sir.
Yeah.
I'm saying we have so many senior people here and they have so many experience. So it would be great for me ki agar aap sab log apne koi point of view this question pe dein. So we have WCCB, we have Forest Department, we have NTCA. But sir, still, the poaching and trading of wildlife animals, their products, still they're going on. So, where we are failing to recover these things, sir?
Krishnamurthy,
we are failing.
Krishnamurthy, just as I told you, that is a big mafia network in a world. It is not managed in India. It is managed by the world mafia. If you search in Google, there are books also. They are asking ki we need 20 tiger skins. So the poor people, they are in our India in the different parts. So they knows where these animals are there. And the poachers are in the villages only. So they will kill those animals and they will provide them. And the same load, it moves to them. So besides police and press department and we doing so many things, also it is happening even press department, our people is having only one stick and one cycle. So he is moving in the national parks, tigers are there, bears are there. So resources are there. In other countries, there are cameras all around and there is a monitoring cell. There are scientists inside the national parks. There are veterinary doctors inside the. So those things are coming up. The government is taking those things and then if it is a full-fledged network will be made with the new technology, then only we will safeguard for money making like that. Due to COVID only we are sitting at one place and otherwise the way we are moving, we are not caring for any food and we are moving day and scooty khadi ki car li udhar se bhaagte udhar ke kabhi kuch kha liya karta banda kuch bhi. अब हम लोगों को डर बैठ गया तो हम लोग जो इस डर से हम सीख रहे हैं वो हमें खुद से पहले से सीखना चाहिए था कि हाथ धोने हैं भाई.
यस सर. यस सर.
के बाद धोने हैं. वी हैव टू कीप आउटसाइड एंड वी हैव टू बी नीट एंड क्लीन. तो नाउ वी हैव विद दिस कोविड इवन वी आर फॉर्चुनेट दैट इंडिया द इम्पैक्ट इज स्टिल लेस. अदरवाइज द वे वी आर मूविंग इन इंडिया सो इट विल स्प्रेड लाइक एनीथिंग एंड सो मेनी डेथ्स एंड ऑल. So with this now, with the COVID, we have to focus. We have not to do these types of things. Even when there is nothing, there is no control. If a dog is coming, people are hitting with a car. Dog hai kya hua, dog hai mar jayega. So same like people are doing with the wild animals also. But now,
yes,
wild animals comes out from their area. Ki bhaiya, ab where you human are? When the 21 days lockdown is happened. So then the animals are, they came out ki kahan gaya animal human movement kahan chalegi. They are all surprised they come out to see us and we are hiding inside. Corona aa gaya. So so that same situation will not come back, we have to be careful and we have to think about conservation and we have to change our habits. Our only mindset set will save us.
Yes sir.
Okay
sir, good evening sir, I'm coming back.
Yes, you are.
Yeah, sir. I am Dr. K. Chandra Bose, calling from Tamil Nadu.
Yes,
sir. I am working in one state university, that is called the Thiruvalluvar University, and you have given very nice lecture, sir. And conservation of mammal diversity, sir. I wanted to know one important things from you that, and recently we used to notice that most of the the marine mammals are being stranded or ashored. So what is the reason behind that? How to control, sir? I wanted to know your expertise over this.
Dr. Neil Mahapatra is also here, and you see the sea, as we all know, 70% is a sea. If sea doesn't like anyone, it will throw the things out. And whatever that exploration is happened in the sea for that oil and other things and all, and their roots by the roots there these animals are moving, even the turtle and these all the whales and dolphins and all, when it is distracted there is no way to move out. So we found them on the seashores. So it is a pity that if some you are from Tamil Nadu, if a ship damaged and all that oil spills, that area becomes totally everything they killed.
So is there any possibility to protect the animal
Animal, you see, if you see the whale to move the whale from the sea, so it will take complete a building inside the mouth.
Yeah.
So how? We are not having that. In other countries, they are having the boats and ships and that, like yeah, that. If some danger happen, they will, by safeguard, they will move them out. Move them from that area to the sea.
What about in India, sir? Is there any possibility?
Dr. Anil will say something. He.
Dr. Shivachandra Bose, actually, yes, Dr. Gaurav Sharma, sir, is an expert of land mammals. We have arranged one special session for marine mammals. In that, sir. I hope you can specially take part and your questions will be rightly answered. And there are many anthropogenic problems in sea. There might be and there might be acoustic problems for which, and there might be natural disasters also for which the marine mammals are facing the major threats. And those things we can discuss in that forum where a specialist from marine mammal group will be answering you all the questions. And Dr. Sharma is an expert of land mammals. So, exactly pinpointing answer to your question will be difficult for him. And we have organized, we'll be organizing another session for marine mammals, which is already scheduled in our that we can discuss these things.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, dear.
Sir, we have almost taken lots of questions and taken 1 hour extra from
that's
your
good, time. That's good. That's good. We will learn from that. We will learn new things.
Yes, sir. So, my sincere thanks to you, sir, for your very elaborative and precise, generalized presentation for all the public so that everyone can take home something from this presentation. My wholehearted thanks for your time and patience, particularly in answering the questions for 1 hour. Thank you very much, sir. I sincerely thank our Honorable Director, sir, Dr. Kailash Chandra, sir, for permitting us to organize such forum and bringing most of the experts to this forum to have an interactive session with all the participants. I thank my senior colleagues and senior participants who are already here and actively participating throughout. Thank you all. And last but not the least, I am thanking all my colleagues here in JDSI and EVRC JDSI for making this occasion a successful one, and it's continuing for more than two and a half months. I hope we'll go a long way with this and we'll bring you many more lucid presentations like today. And one more thing I will add, like to announce here, that people are asking more often about e-certificate. We have declared in all the groups that e-certificate will be provided only after the series. Even if you take part in single lecture, you will be given the certificate. It's really tough for us to provide a person 50 certificate, and 50 certificates will be useless for you, trust me, but we'll provide you the certificate in the end of this series. And next, after this, we'll have the lecture from Dr. Rajmohana on the parasitic Hymenoptera of India, an overview in the next Friday. The timing will be from 12 to 1. I sincerely thank everybody, and my special thanks to Dr. Gaurav Sharma for his presence, and thank you all. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Participant, BDO mein aana chahe to aa sakte hain. BDO on karna chahe participant to. Thank you, Sanjeev ji. Thank you, Kumar ji. Thank you, Anil, for organizing. I see. Thanks so much.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks so much. Thanks.
Sir, can I have your email ID?
Thank you so much.
Yeah,
Dr. Anil, Dr. Zriti is here. Dr. Zriti.
Thank you.
How are you, madam?
I'm fine. How are you guys?
Fine.
Yeah, thank you. Hum pura suna, sabko dekha bhi.
Madam, when are you back?
October.
Are you back?
October. After completing.
अरे फ्लाइट चलेगा तब ना घुसने देगा तब तो दे आर नॉट लेटिंग मी इनसाइड
वहीं पे जेडेसाई वो बना दीजिए मैडम ऑफिस, जेडेसाई का एक सेंटर खोल दीजिए।
हाँ चलो वही करते हैं, मेरे घर के पास खाली है उधर बना दे। अरे
ये तो लेगा।
प्रणाम सर जी।
प्रणाम प्रणाम
मैडम, वी हैव टू फिक्स योर प्रोग्राम आल्सो, व्हेन यू विल बी कमिंग बैक ओनली।
व्हेन आई गो बैक देन।
या
In case you want to do anything on mosquito, you can ask Dr. Suman for it.
No, you have to give also Suman, Dr. Suman.
Madam, आप दीजिए वहीं से दीजिए, लंदन से दीजिए.
Your name is there already in the list.
एक अब्रोड से हो जाएगा presentation जेड साहब में, from abroad.
International webinar.
और क्या?
No, actually I am looking for tickets. So agar koi bhi din booking ho jayega and if the date coincides, but then I am ready. You know, I can. Tell me kya, send me something, I'll date.
Aap apne group pe, you will deliver a lecture of your expertise. There is no that, there is nothing ki you have to specifically, you have to speak. Aapka jo experience hai 20 years, 30 years ka, you give a presentation.
Okay, I think if it goes on, then you preferably keep me in October.
Yes, madam. Before Durga Puja.
Before Durga Puja, yeah.
So I request all to clap for Dr. Anil. So we will make a one clap for Dr. Anil for organizing every week. Thank you all of you. Thank you, madam. Thank you so much. Thank you. Bye.
Dr. Anil, send me the links for the other lectures also. I don't get the links.
Yes, madam. I'll add you to the WhatsApp group.
Yeah, because Gaurav sent me the link, that is why I could join. Most of the cases
I are today.
Yeah, because if I don't get the link, I cannot join.
Okay, I'll add you to the group.
Okay. Thank you.
One big national seminar is on 23rd September, madam, in which we ask for abstracts and full